Good morning students, let's learn today proportion. Now what is proportion? A proportion is an equation that states that two ratios are equal. What is proportion? A proportion is an equation that states the two ratios are equal. Okay, the general form of proportion may be written as, see, general form of proportion may be written as A is to B. What it is written? A is to B and C is to D. See, the general form of proportion may be written as A is to B and C is to D. Or A is to B proportion C is to D. Okay, so how to read these? A is to B and C is to D. See, A is to B and C is to D. Okay, so how to read this? Understood? These are four terms in the proportion. Okay, these are the four terms in this proportion: A, B, C, and D. These are the four terms in this proportion. Okay, so what is proportion? Understood? How to write it is understood. How to read it is understood. See, A is to B and C is to D, or we can write this way also. A is to B, C, here it is given symbol proportion, C is to D. Okay, so understood. Now see, A is to B and C is to D. Now in this outer term, see which are the outer terms? See, these and these outside. This both the terms are outside. So for that outside terms, what we have to say? The extremes. What we have to say? This outer term. See, A and B. These are the outer. See, these both are outside. Okay, outer terms. So what we have to say for this? Extremes. Extremes. For these outer terms, what we have to say? Extremes. And now see these terms. Inner terms, what we have to say? The means. What we have to say for these? Means. These are the outer terms. So now see here, these are the outer terms. See, A and D. A and D, outer terms. So what we have to say for that? Extremes. And B and C, these are the inner terms. So what we have to say for that? Means. Okay, see here, I will show you this. See here, these are the means. Okay, and these are the extremes. These both A and B extremes. And now what these, see these four dots, what we have to say for this proportion? What we have to say for this proportion? See, these are the means, these are the extremes, and this is proportion. Okay, so now product of means is equal to product of extremes. Proportion, for any proportion, product of means, product of means is equal to product of extremes. Product of extremes. Okay, so for any proportion, product of means is equal to product of extremes. Consider this proportion. Okay, now what I said, product of means is equal to product of extremes. Now product of means, see, product of means. Okay, and product is equal to product of extreme. Now which are the extreme? 4 and 5, these are the extreme, and which are the means? 20 and 1. Okay, so let's see 20. So product of means is equal to product of extreme we got. So they are in proportion. So this is proportion. It is given this we consider proportion. So product of means is equal to product of extreme. This is what we have taken. See, this is A, this is B, C and D. Okay. So A is to B. A is to B. How we are writing? See, in ratio A upon B is equal to C upon D. Okay. A upon B is equal to C upon D. A is to B is equal to C is to D. A is to B as C is to D. Okay. So A is to B as C is to D. Now see what we did. Product of means. Means means what it is? B and C. We did the product of B and C. And A and D. So what we can do? See, these also we can take cross product of that. A into D is equal to B into C. B into C. So their cross products are equal. In proportion, their cross products are equal. See, cross product. A into D. A into D. Extremes are these. Okay. And B into C. B into C. So what we can say in proportion, their cross products are equal. See, here we get the same thing. See. Here I will write this value. A is to B means what we have written here? 4 is to 20 means 4 upon 20. Okay. As C is to D. C is to D means 1 upon 5. So their cross product C 4 into 5. Okay. Is equal to 1 into 2. 20. Cross product C 4 into 5. And 1 into 20. Okay. So what we will get here? 4 5s are 20 and 21s are 20. So in proportion their cross products are equal. So practice at point 3 question number 1. Are the following numbers in proportion? So let's check. So what we will do first? Ratio of 16 is to 18 we will find. Okay, first let's find the ratio of 16 is to 18 and ratio of 8 is to 9. Okay, so ratio of 16 is to 18. So write 16 is to 18 means 16 upon 18. Ratio we have to write as a fraction. 16 is to 18 means 16 upon 18. Okay. Now 16 upon 18. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. Let's do the reduced term for this. Okay. 2 9s are 18. 2 8s are 16. So what we got? 8 upon 9. So what we got? 8 upon 9. Now next, ratio of 8 is to 9. Okay. So ratio of 8 is to 9. 8 is to 9 means 8 upon 9. Ratio of 8 is to 9 means 8 upon 9. So still we can do the reduced term for this. Lowest term we can do for this. See, both the numbers are divisible by any same number. No. So 8 upon 9 will come. So if you will see ratio of 16 is to 18, what we got? 8 is to 9, we got 8 upon 9. Ratio of 8 is to 9, what we got? 8 is to 9. So both the ratios are equal. So they are in proportion. Okay. So 16. So what we will write? Therefore 16, 18, 9 are in proportion. Okay. So these are in proportion. Now let's solve next one example. Ratio of 12 and 15 first we'll find. Okay. Ratio of 12 is to 15. Okay. 12 is to 15. So 12 is to 15 means 12 upon 15. Let's write ratio in the fraction. We can write ratio as a fraction. Okay. So 12 upon 15. Okay. So now 12 upon 15, if you will see, these both the numbers are there in which table? These both the numbers are divisible by which number? what we got? 4 upon 5 we got. Okay. Now let's find the ratio of 8 is to 10. Okay. Ratio of 8 is to 10. Okay. So now 8 to 10 means 8 is to 10 means 8 upon 10. Okay. Now 8 upon 10. Let's do the reduced term. Okay. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. Both the numbers are divisible by 2. 2 5s are 10. 2 4s are 8. So what we got? 4 upon 5. So see. Here we got the ratios are equal. 12 to 15. What we got? 4 is to 5. When we have done the reduced term for this. 12 is to 15. What we got? 4 is to 5. And when we did the reduced term for 8 is to 10. What we got? 4 is to 5. Means both the ratios we got equal. Okay. So they are in proportion. So right here therefore 12, 15, 8, 10.